for retaliation, of course, growing, Sumit, but multifold, multifold retribution, be it economically, be it, of course, militarily, or be it diplomatically.
Right. Uday, first of all, thank you very much for having me on the show. The point here is, if you see the response, is exactly what Prime Minister responded. You see the words. You see one striking similarity when Pulwama happened and when Honorable Prime Minister responded, he exactly responded with the same words. He said, Inki shahadat zaya nahi hogi. The sacrifice of our brave men will not go for vain. And we see exactly a same response. Even the words measure up to the same response. They are exactly the same. So we have seen what happened after Pulwama. We have seen the surgical strikes. We have seen the paradigm with Pakistan relations change altogether. Now, we cannot be with a survey is that no bullet is fired, because unfortunately, China has crossed the Rubicon. Whatever happened in the last 50 years is gone by. So our policy for the last 50 years is also gone by. China has crossed the Rubicon. 20 of our people are dead. It doesn't matter, did you fire a bullet or you did not fire a bullet, but you have really killed 20 of our people, and that changes the whole paradigm. Let it be military, let it be economic, social, commercial, strategic. Everything has changed in the last 2 days. And Prime Minister categorically weighing that these 20 people's sacrifices will not go in vain. It's a 360-degree message, because what we are trying to China, look, whatever happened in 50 years, whatever was the policy, it has all changed. Military-wise, all options are open to us. And we have to give a message to China. We have to call this Chinese bluff, Uday, because we are a nuclear triad. We are the third biggest, you know, military power in the world, and nobody can come and push.